Hello students, we are continuing the first chapter, Rotational Dynamics. We are going to learn today here theorem of parallel axis. There is one more theorem, its name is theorem of perpendicular axis, but here now we are going to learn theorem of parallel axis. There is a statement for this theorem. What is the statement? The moment of inertia of any object about any axis is equal to the sum of its moment of inertia about an axis which is passing through center of mass and parallel to the given axis, and the product of the mass of the object and square of the distance between two parallel axes. So, if we apply this statement to this figure, first let us try to understand what is this figure about. You can see the object of any shape. There are two parallel axes, one of them is passing through point O, the other is passing through point C. C is the center of mass here. The distance between two parallel axes is h. If IO is the moment of inertia about any given axis, so according to statement, IO, the moment of inertia of an object about any given axis, is equal to the sum of its moment of inertia about an axis passing through center of mass, means IC, and the product of mass of an object, suppose if capital M is the mass of the object, so M into square of the distance between two parallel axes. So square of distance H is the distance between two axes, so we can write here H square. See, this is the mathematical form of the statement. Means mathematical statement wise, you can repeat the statement, the moment of inertia of any object about any given axis of rotation is equal to the sum of its moment of inertia about an axis passing through center of mass and the product of the mass of object and square of the distance between two parallel axes. So this is the statement. Now we have to give the proof for this theorem. How can we prove this theorem? First, you have to write here, consider an object of mass M. O is the point through which any axis MOP passes and the body is rotating about this axis. C is the center of mass through which an axis ACB is passing. The two axes are taken parallel and the distance between two axes is h. Suppose dm is the mass of the element situated at point d. D is such a point where the small element of the object is taken and its mass is dm. Capital M is the mass of the complete object and dm is the mass of a small element which is situated at point d. Now in the figure you can see that dn is drawn perpendicular on OC produced. If OC is produced, we see the dn is perpendicular on it. And DC and DO are joined here. So the moment of inertia about an axis MOP, if we consider the axis MOP, the moment of inertia IO can be written as integration of square of the distance. See, the distance of D from point O is OD and OD square into mass of element. Element which is situated at point D and its mass is dm. So OD square into dm, this is moment of inertia about an axis passing through point O. In the same way, we can write the MI about an axis ACB. If we write axis ACB, the moment of inertia about this axis is IC and it can be written as integration of distance CD square into DM. DM is again the mass of the element and the distance of the element from the center of mass is CD square of that distance. Now if we take this IO and continue it writing further, we get the proof for the mathematical statement. So let us take IO is equal to, first you can write here, now IO is equal to integration of OD square into DM. OD square, if you look at the figure in triangle ODN, N is the right angle, so it is a right angle triangle. If you apply the Pythagoras theorem here, you can see OD square is equal to DN square plus ON square. So in place of OD square, we can write DN square plus ON square. Therefore, IO is equal to integration of OD square means DN square plus ON square into DM as it is. Now, if you see in a figure, ON is made up of two segments, NC and OC. So in place of ON, we can write NC plus OC. Let us write the next step. IO is equal to integration of, let us take here square bracket, DN square as it is, DN square plus ON should be written inside the bracket. ON is made up of two segments, NC plus OC. Let us write here NC plus OC and bracket square. As there is a square to ON, and if this is ON, which is written in terms of two segments, so there should be the square. Square bracket complete, multiplied by DM as it is, DM. Now let us apply the formula here, A plus B bracket square, so that we can split this bracket. Next step will be integration of DN square plus A square means here NC square plus 2AB means 2NC into OC plus B square means OC square multiplied by DM as it is. Now here, if you look at these two terms, DN square plus NC square, you can see in triangle DNC, DN square plus NC square is DC square. Means again applying here Pythagoras theorem, as it is a right angle triangle. So in place of these two terms, we can write integration of DC square plus 2NC into OC plus OC square into DM. Now what we will do in the next step, we will split this integration sign to each and every term, and we will multiply DM to every term. So the next step will be integration of DC square into DM plus integration of 2NC into OC into DM plus integration of OC square into DM. Now here we can put value of OC. See, OC is a distance edge. So we can write DC square into DM plus integration of 2 into NC into edge into DM plus integration of OC means again H, OC square means H square into DM. But H is a constant, the distance between these two parallel axes is constant, and you know that the constants do not have integration. So this H can be taken outside the integration sign. Next step, DC square into DM will be as it is, plus here constant is 2H, 2H can be taken outside the integration. What remains inside? NC into DM plus H square is again constant, taken outside, remains only integration of DM. The left hand side is IO written here. Now the first term is integration of DC square DM is IC. See here, DC square into DM is IC. So we can write here integration of DC square into DM is IC. And here integration of DM, what is meaning of integration of DM? If dm is the mass of a small element of the object, and if we put integration, means we are adding the mass of all the elements which is the body consists of, so it will be the total mass of the object. So integration of dm means total mass of the object. And if we think about the middle term, that is twice h integration of nc into dm, here nc is the distance of point n from the center of mass, and if the mass of the body is distributed symmetrically around the center of mass, according to the definition of center of mass, this integration of nc into dm is equal to zero. Now if we put all these three values in the above equation, we get io is equal to integration of dc square into dm is ic, putting that value, plus twice h as it is, this value integration of nc into dm is 0, writing this value 0, plus h square into integration of dm is capital M. So the next step will be io is equal to ic plus this value is totally 0, twice h multiplied by 0 means becomes complete 0. So no need to write this middle term. So remains plus mh square, and in this way we get the mathematical form of the statement of theorem of parallel axis. See here. So this is the final result. In this way we can prove the theorem step by step. First you have to remember the statement, draw the figure, and then stepwise you can prove this theorem. If you find out difficulty one time, if you see this video, see the video twice or more than two times, you will automatically understand the theorem. How to prove it? It is very easy. Okay.